It's taking a long time.
Just wait.
No, I know.
How long is the intro?
I don't know. I just know the one line.
Kid, I don't want to have to wait for the entire song.
No. It has to be a natural progression choice.
I might cut it.
No. You see, we don't want money. We'll just have it. We'll just have
it. Wait, listen.
Is it gonna show up at some point?
This is. Like, here we go. That's what I wanted. Okay. I wanted.
Okay.
Barracuda! As a kid, did you ever play superheroes? Did you ever create your own superheroes?
Did you ever then take those characters and create an entire universe off the back of them? Well, we did. And over the years, that universe has actually grown into something we're truly proud of. But that's not what this podcast is about. This podcast is about reaching to the back of the fridge to talk about the first characters we ever created. The ones we made up in 5 minutes just so our friends could play make-believe with us. The ones we scribbled onto notebook paper while waiting for our kids' meals. Back then, we thought those characters were legendary. But now, well, we'll let you be the judge of that. This is the Retcon Microwave. Let's reheat some leftovers.
Hello and welcome back to the Retcon Microwave, the show where we take our old characters, creatures, and creations and try to fit them into their own amalgam universe that makes sense. My name is Chase. I'm joined, as always, by my two co-hosts, Caden.
Barracuda.
And Noah.
Barracuda.
Okay, now how are y'all doing tonight?
We're doing good. How about you, Noah?
Barracuda.
Yeah, Barracuda.
You can tell.
All right, so what should I expect from Barracuda?
Barracuda.
Because I know that's this character's name.
I honestly don't know what to expect from this one either, but I have ideas already, so I'm excited.
Yeah, so this week we're talking about the Barracuda.
Second fish themed.
I actually debated if I should cancel this episode and do another villain. Because
no, I think we're
I think
committed.
This is the natural progression of things. This,
we
this
have
feels
a lot of
right.
I don't think there's an order to any of this.
Can
so.
I look at this now, or you want us to wait?
Yeah, well, let me give you a bit of a backstory.
Okay.
So this, of course, this appeared in the same book that the Jaguar appeared in, Animal Works Superheroes by Caden. And the third page is the Barracuda, superhero.
Barracuda!
So please turn over your papers.
Alright, let's see this.
Oh my god.
Oh man, he's got a villain. Like, just, he's got a rogue gallery, man.
Yeah, no,
look
he
at
has
this.
A huge rogue
oh my god.
Gallery. Holy cow, look at that.
Barracuda! He's also riding like a.
A barracuda.
I guess.
It's like a big barracuda.
It doesn't, look,
big
it doesn't
barracuda.
Look anything like a barracuda.
It's either a really big barracuda or he's... Barracuda's not that big, right? So maybe he's really small?
No, they're not. They're pretty big. I mean,
No.
But they're not that big.
They're not that big. Unless
like,
he is very small.
They're like,
I do kind
they're
of
like human-sized, at least.
Maybe he's. Maybe that's like a genetically mutated... Okay, well, here's also
barracuda!
Do you see the one-line description given for him?
Born half barracuda, half human.
Whoa.
Oh, no way.
I really like how the half of him that is barracuda is just, like, it's just his head.
Yeah.
Everything else is just human, so he doesn't really have mobility.
Is he
in
naked,
the water.
Too? Like, he's got to be naked, right?
Okay, he's...
Yeah.
Or is his skin, like, just... Or is he just, like, a humanoid, like, Silver Surfer?
Is he, like, a humanoid, like... Okay, so... What here? I'll describe the picture for anybody that's not it can't see it.
And then you can also go on the YouTube channel and look at the picture. We have the website and we also have a picture. If you're listening to this and you go to our YouTube, what is it?
The Retcon Microwave.
The Retcon Microwave on YouTube, and we also have a picture of what we're looking at up while we listen to the podcast.
I'd also say go to the website, especially because you can see all the every photo I can find of this guy. I will put on the website.
Yeah, so it's really nice about that. I like that.
So it's like. It's obviously underwater. It's like a humanoid barracuda dude riding another barracuda. And then underneath him, he has
that's
eight.
Gills.
Huh?
That's gotta be gills, right?
Oh, I thought that was like a weird...
No, that's definitely sack. Gills.
Oh.
Okay.
It's gotta be gills.
So he can't breathe out of water. All right.
No, he can breathe.
Oh.
Well, he's half man, half barracuda. I feel like we didn't linger on that long enough.
No, I don't think... But I
feel like...
Do you want him to be able to breathe both?
We'll get to that bridge when we. Okay. Well, you know, right now it's water under the bridge. But, right. You know, get it? It was a barracuda
under the bridge.
It was a barracuda under the bridge.
Barracuda.
Oh yeah. So also he has like eight villains specifically for him.
That's definitely sick. Unless you only. Oh, we only got six.
Oh, you only have three on your. No, there's eight total.
Okay.
Oh, there's two more.
Yeah. The.
Jeez.
I guess your copy didn't go all the way. It's full on. It's eight villains.
Dang, man.
Okay, that explains the top, because for the A is cut out, and I didn't really see it as a D at first, so I thought it just says he's Barracool.
No, yeah.
I see that, yeah. Barracool.
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 All right. Barracool. Yeah. So, that is...
I like how we're all kind of too tired to deal with this guy. We're all really, like, just looking at this guy, and we're like, oh, we have to come up with a life for this dude.
Give me a second, let me grab my thing. I guess I didn't prepare as well for this episode, but I have a whole, like, I'll cut this part out. I have a whole.
No, don't cut it.
No.
Barracuda.
Barracuda.
He's got it. I'm putting my foot down right now.
Mm-hmm.
That is his theme song.
Barracuda.
And yes.
Maybe he just sings it to himself while he's going along.
I want it to inexplicably happen in the background. Every time he breaches the water.
Yeah,
Barracuda.
Barracuda. It cuts off every time he re-enters the water.
Barracuda. So, also, he kind of looks like James Gunn's King Shark. A little bit.
In the fact that...
In his expression.
I guess
you
I can...
You see the expression? He's kind of got this derpy smile.
He does. He has a very... There's not much going on there.
And also, I clearly didn't know what a barracuda looked like, because this looks nothing like a barracuda. It looks like a weird potato with a mouth.
I do appreciate the fact that there really is nothing going on behind those eyes.
Yeah.
That's pretty much the only thing. Yeah, that's the only thing going on in his head.
No, like, really, he literally is just like... So, he looks like... He really just looks like a weird look. Like, he looks like he's half human, half fish, and it's not... It didn't go well. He really is... He does look like James Gunn's King Shark.
Here's my question. Yeah. How did he get like that? How did he become...
Well, we know the obvious answer that's coming into all of our heads, but we have to avoid that answer at all costs.
I don't want that to be
the case. I don't want it to be the case either. I want it to be... What do you think? What do you think?
Maybe just the human spawn from two normal barracuda is just, you know?
Oh, it just happened to be
half human for some
Like
reason.
Two barracudas did regular spawning and then all of a sudden...
And then he popped out?
He popped out?
Yeah.
No, that's not satisfying. That's I think weird. It's funny.
Yeah.
It's kind of funny.
It's funny.
Yeah. To me, that would explain his derpiness somehow, but I don't know.
No, I feel like we could... What if we had, like, a boat with a family on it was going, like, 80 miles an hour in the water, and then a barracuda collided with a four-year-old, and, like...
Rather than, like, the natural of, rather than, like, clearly just a bunch of gore and flesh flying across for the both.
Maybe that does happen. Dad is a scientist and he has to bring the child back to life. But he like just has to sew parts together.
He just like scoops up the congealed ooze.
Scoops up the butter like ooze.
Puts it into a mold.
Oh my god. And reanimates it.
Sticks it in the ice chest that was reserved for
like
fish.
Like a McDonald's chicken nugget.
I hate the disturbingness of this character already. Because clearly he couldn't save his son's face. Because he had to make it a barracuda.
Yeah.
So
the barracuda snatched off his son's face.
Oh, okay, well, here's
there
the thing.
You go.
We will make a better son.
Oh, God. Here's an interesting fact. You don't have to keep this in. An interesting fact about barracudas is that they can slice you open without even opening their mouths. Because when their mouths are closed, they make natural, almost scissors. Like, their faces are natural box cutters.
Okay.
So, a lot of danger from barracudas just comes from them ramming into you.
Okay.
Okay.
We can utilize that.
I saw a River Monsters episode about it.
Very cool.
It was very good. No, like, literally, their jaws form like scissors when they're even when their face is closed, it's like their jaws are almost like scissors when you hit that perfect cut.
Yeah.
That's basically what it is. It's more like a box cutter, because that doesn't... Yeah, but it's like, that's what barracudas are. He's very weird.
So does he bite off the kid's head, or does he just slice his neck?
I like the idea that it was just an impact.
Okay.
It was just like the barracuda jumped out of the water, and it was just, like, I'm kind of sad, because I don't really want it to be the scientist's son. I'm like, I just kind of want it to be some random kid.
I don't care. I want this son.
What if it was like an orphan? I feel less bad
worse.
If it was an orphan.
That's worse. That's worse.
What if it was like just some random stowaway, like,
"Hi, Mr. Captain, I'm stowing away on the boat, and I'm trying to get some little shippy stuff, and I'm living my life and sweeping the deck."
Well, he's British now, so he deserves it.
What if a family is on a cruise, they're going along, they're having a day, but it's kind of stormy outside, and they're like, "What's going on?" And the fish are all agitated, and at the moment, they're like, going 90 miles an hour, a barracuda jumps out of
barracuda!
The water.
Barracuda!
Red.
Barracuda.
A barracuda jumps out of the water. The kid and him collide at the exact moment a bolt of lightning strikes
Whoa!
Them.
Bolt of lightning!
Bolt of lightning! I love that.
And
I
then, like,
that.
The smoke settles, and the dad's like, "Son, are you all right?" And the, like, barracuda walks out, just kind of hobbles out.
I really want it to be really grotesque. Like, I want it to, like, when you look at it, you feel uncomfortable, and you see him riding other barracudas, like, jumping into battle, and you're like, and you hear the barracuda, but it's just like, this thing is horrible.
Oh, maybe do we want to keep him like pretty looking for it?
No, what? I want him to be ugly. Eyes to be facing different directions.
So he's literally just like a melted together.
Yeah, no, he's a weird little creature that's been melted together. That's honestly, before we even started recording this episode, I thought from memory. This image, I only remember the fish part of it.
Oh, okay.
So I was just like, I don't really know what else to do. I wanted him to be this little gremlin, but it's now kind of naturally turned into this.
He looks like a little gremlin.
He is a little gremlin.
A little gremlin.
There's
not much going on there.
I thought he was an adult. Should he be an adult? I mean, I don't know if I don't want him to be like 7. I don't want him to do another Sharky.
That is pretty crazy.
We already do have Sharky like that. That's true.
If he's a kid, he should be like a teenager, maybe 17-ish. If we're going young.
That's too. I feel like he should be. I feel like 17, it doesn't feel like the right age. It needs to be maybe even older than that. But I do like the.
Well, make him an adult. Maybe.
Okay, maybe his origin happens as a kid, but at this point later on, he's already an adult. So he's grown up.
Or what if maybe the boat, he was driving the boat, he was trying to impress some girl, and then maybe he was a rich guy and this is him being taught a lesson.
Whatever is the ugliest outcome for this character, I want.
Yeah.
Clearly he was the product of a mentally ill mind and he needs to be
you.
Yeah, I mean, I didn't nobody's disputing that. Yeah. I'm saying we need to punish me. We need to punish this person in light of me.
Want to take a break?
He's got very short legs, by the way.
Yeah.
They're non-existent. I want to keep it all.
Okay.
Short legs, like he's just not mobile on land.
I want him to be, like, when you see him.
Oh, yeah.
Like, it's your savior, but oh, God. I'm saved, finally, but I wish.
I saw what else did.
Yeah, I wish I was blind or something. Like, yeah. I just hate this thing. I hate it so much.
It is a little unpleasant to look at. Question. Oh, sorry.
I was just gonna. I kind of like that concept. So he keeps, like, maybe this guy, he's like, you know, there's not much going behind his head, but he has the idea of being a superhero.
Yeah.
So he's really, like, he goes out of his way to save a lot of people, but every time he saves them, they are just not appreciative.
Yeah.
And would rather drown. Yeah. And so, like, you know, maybe at some point he encounters one person who actually gives him attention for something.
Yeah.
I don't know. And he's like, oh my gosh, finally.
Serpent Woman.
Huh? Serpent woman.
Is he like our Aquaman?
No, that's Jaguar.
What?
No, he's not our Aquaman. Our Aquaman.
Like, he's.
He's definitely not, because look at him.
No, obviously he's
not.
He
works
like
for
a,
Aquaman.
He's not a ruler. But, like, is he our Aquaman in the sense that he's our sea base? He's our main sea based hero, and he can.
I don't want
He's our King Shark. But,
yes.
Like, significantly. Like, rather than being terrified,
he's way derpier.
He's just, like. Again, like, I don't think people that are rescued by him, they're not really scared by his looks. They're not terrified of his looks. It's just like, oh my god.
It's disturbing.
You are disturbing. What are you?
Yes.
You know?
It's disturbing.
Put off.
Yeah.
He's very disturbing, and I feel like he wouldn't, like, stop. I feel like he would eat a child.
I feel like he has a speech impediment.
Yes.
Yeah.
I'm okay with that.
I imagine in water he's pretty graceful, but on land he just goes.
What if he was like
waddles around?
No, I don't want that. Never mind. I was going to say, what if he has a British accent in the water and like on land he's like, I guess a Cockney British accent. But I mean, it doesn't matter. I mean, I think it's funny, but I don't even want him to talk, honestly.
Can he talk to
I
fish?
Want him to make disturbing noises.
Because obviously he communicates with barracudas, but can he talk to other fish?
I wouldn't picture him communicating with any form of fish whatsoever.
Or life.
He's riding a barracuda. I mean, unless he just grabs that thing.
I like that.
He just grabs random fish.
He doesn't look happy that he's on it.
No, he does. He's not. He's an outcast from barracudas.
You know who he looks like? Manny from Diary of a Wimpy Kid. He looks like Manny.
Oh my god, I see.
And that's what I've been thinking of this whole time.
He does kind of look like Manny.
He looks like Manny from Diary of a Wimpy Kid. Like the book.
Yes.
And I want, like, that's his facial expression to me constantly when I look at this. I see.
Okay.
Barracuda.
Let me go back to his age. So, are we thinking, like, 25-year-old older dude, or are we thinking teenager? What are we thinking here?
I stand by the idea that it's a child. Maybe I just have a lot of unresolved anger towards children. But, like...
It's sadder to me if he's a child.
I know, but that's...
that's what makes it charmful.
And I'm not saying he's, like, has to be, like, a sharky. Like, he has to be 7 years old with a mentality of a 7-year-old. I'm saying he was a child at one point, and now he's a monster and a freak.
I like that his origin
people try to sell him in fish markets.
I like that his origin is it happens when he's a kid, but I don't want it. Like, I think he should be a full-grown adult by the time we follow his events.
I'm okay with that compromise. Yeah.
Okay.
Because look at him. Look at him.
I picture him as
I hate
funny.
Him.
Maybe he can't speak. I keep saying I picture him. Like, I picture, if there's a battle coming on, he hops up onto the deck. He scuttles over and he like bites a dude.
And he waddles. Like his arms are longer than his legs.
Yeah.
And I love that.
He propels himself forward with his arms.
Like out of all the characters we've talked about, I've never wanted to draw one more than this guy.
Yeah.
Like I really want to draw him.
Okay. I would love it if you do.
I want to show you. Oh god, I just had an image in my head. I want to show you what I see when I look at him.
But I think so by the time we meet him, I guess he could be, I mean honestly, age doesn't, he didn't even really have to have a defined age.
No, I feel like that works against the character to have a defined age.
Yeah. So it's just, it happened at a certain point at an undefined time ago, and now he's here.
Yeah.
I mean, honestly, we could throw in a mystery. Did it happen as a kid, or was he the person driving the boat?
I guess we can do that. Yeah, but I like, I don't know.
I agree. Yeah, I see what you're saying. I like the idea of, like, I just have a picture in my head of the three elements combining into this thing, but like the lightning, the child, and the barracuda. But barracuda.
If I were to throw him in a story, I would not tell the origin like 3 years of this character being in existence, and I would have him. I wouldn't do it through dialogue. I would have him start talking in an unintelligible fish language, and like you see his imagination. And you're like, what's going on there? And you see a boat, a barracuda, a bolt of lightning, and then he walks out.
Oh, I would love that. And it's cut out animation, too.
Yeah. And then everyone else is like, what? Everyone's kind of like, wait, what did you say?
This is real?
And they're like, wait, were you the one driving? Were you the kid? Yeah. And blah, 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 and they can't.
Yeah, no, also.
That's actually really good. I like that.
Here's one a little side thought, I guess. Like, but I like this character because I've always been a fan of the characters in established universes that are just monsters that exist.
Yeah.
I know it's not a great movie, but you remember Earth's Mightiest Heroes, The Next Generation or whatever, where it was all the kid Avengers? Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Remember how they went and found the Hulk
and
he was just this monster living in a cave? Like, it was Bruce Banner, but like, he was the secret weapon that Ultron never killed. I love those characters.
Yeah.
They still exist somewhere and you can find them, and I like that Barracuda is kind of that. Like, I imagine he shows up in a end of a battle and it's like, oh my god, it's Barracuda.
Yeah.
Barracuda. And the music plays in the background when he leaps out of the water on his, like, Barracuda fishing like a dolphin.
It's very much a Deus Ex Machina character.
Yes, I really like those characters. Here's what I imagine when I hear this song. I know I've said it before, but I just imagine, like, they're in the battle, right? Everybody's fighting each other. And then, like, they're like, oh, all hope is lost. And all you hear, like, bye! And then, like, you just see him, like, launch out of the water. His little tiny legs are flopping as he leaps out of the water on his barracuda. And he's just, like, this, like, ultra-realistic SpongeBob gross-up fish head on the dude. And he's just, like,
Because of his disfiguration, he really doesn't have proper mobility. So he just crashes back into the water every single time.
Also, a thought that I've been having for the past, like, 5 minutes and I haven't said out loud. He should use the Barracuda as a weapon. Like, he should be using a Smash Bros, like, spinning it around as it, like, hitting people with his fish.
So he just kills Barracudas.
It's alive, but, like, no, I mean, it's hitting people a lot.
He's using it as his sword?
No, he's just, like, spinning in a circle with it, like, outstretched, so and it's what, hitting people.
Like I'm saying, he is killing the Barracudas.
We're not confirming that. We can't. We're not on the scene. You know, we don't know if the Barracuda's alive or not.
Yeah.
All we know is the Barracuda's skull is colliding with a lot of things.
Yeah. Okay. I imagine the whole Barracuda, he like lands on the little ship, wherever they are, and they're all like, oh my god, it's the Barracuda! And then he just starts wrecking shop.
Waluigi have that? No, not Waluigi. What doesn't Wario have that in Smash Bros, where he
where he bites a person?
No, where he spins around with something. Or am I thinking of Luigi or something?
No, well, Wario does a little...
Something like that.
Anyways, let's get to these villains here.
Yeah, I was thinking about that too.
Yeah. So we got the Barracuda done, I think. I think he is noble in stopping things. Like, he's not like an idiot. He's can't speak, and it looks like there's nothing on
there. It looks like he's an idiot. Yeah. It has to be that way, though.
Yes,
it looks
definitely.
Like he's an idiot. But it has to be that.
He is stopping crimes on purpose.
I relate to it too much.
He is going stopping crimes on purpose. Like,
yeah, no, I agree with that.
He may wander into the crimes, but he makes the
choice. He's not Jar Jar Binks.
Yeah,
he's
not Jar Jar.
First villain is Atlantic Assassin.
Atlantis
Assassin, sorry.
Kills Atlantis.
It's like a hammerhead. If you took an octopus but replaced a big old bulge head with a hammerhead.
Yeah, there's nothing much to say about this. He's
definitely
a gun for
hire. He's an assassin, so yeah.
So he's killing fish? I don't know.
Maybe it's almost like a Godzilla situation where he has to be the king. Of, like, if there's just other apex predators
that,
you know,
collided with lightning and humans,
that, but yes, they all collided. These are all creatures that collided together and were struck by lightning.
That's like, this is a phenomenon that's been happening for a while.
They all start attacking the land and attacking boats and stuff,
yeah.
But he was the one that was combined and struck with lightning, but also a human.
You know what they look like? They look like the monsters that lived in the trench in the SpongeBob movie. Like, you remember all the mods?
They do.
Like, because we're men. Like that, they look like they belong there.
What is the third one? There's Atlantis Assassin, there's Crabman, and then there's
Crab Monster.
Yeah, no, creatively bankrupt.
I'll run through the villains real fast. So we have Atlantis Assassin. He looks kind of like an octopus thing. Crabman,
which is a crab with like Star Wars fish alien heads.
Yeah. So there's Crab Man. There's also Crab Monster. Either Crab Man is a society and Crab Monster is their, like,
God.
God.
That would be cool.
I like that, but yeah. I also like the idea, the option that it could be just, like, Crab Man's final form.
Oh, yeah. Well, would you like the idea that it's a society of, like, crab people and they can all transform into this in times of high stress?
I do. I think remember what was the monster that we had last week that was in the forest?
Secret Keeper?
No, the other one.
Fang?
Yes, Fang. Like, that was a swarm, and I feel like another swarm
would
not.
Would
it
be a swarm? There's a finite
and I think
number.
I'm just being annoying, but like, I feel like I'm just being finicky, but it to me it feels like the same. I mean, I think
the thing is, there's so many here.
Yeah.
Do we want all these to be individual things?
No, I mean, yeah. Or do
I
understand
that. Yeah.
I like the idea that there's a crab society, like an Atlantis underneath the sea, but it's all crab. I'm imagining the crab people, that society. I don't imagine them as villains. I just imagine them as a society.
And maybe there's one evil one.
Yeah, there might be one evil one, but I think it's just...
As much as
they're just, they live. They're just people.
Okay.
They just live under the sea.
Yeah. Does he live with them?
He could.
Like
he could
have a little village, like a little timeshare there.
He could have an apartment.
A timeshare?
Yeah.
Yeah, he has a timeshare. He shares it with a barracuda.
The fourth one on mine is the mega shark.
That is... It's a shark.
Yeah.
I say we make it a regular shark.
But I don't...
Because I can't imagine it being anything... Remember whenever you said a second ago... Didn't you say a second ago some of these are just things that he killed? That's probably what that is.
Like, it's gotta be, right?
I think it's
a shark that was attacking people at a beach... And by attacking, like, it didn't even kill anybody, but he was like, all right, let me take care of it.
Yeah, I could
like it
see
maybe
that.
It was maybe a Soul Surfer situation. Okay, so the clam monster is next.
He's got a crown.
No, he has big sharp teeth, and he has a crown. He has a crown.
These are just strange monsters. Like, they're not anything behind them, but this clam monster should be, like, one of those stupidly large
Yeah.
Do we want one giant one, or do we want, like, another? There's a bunch of them, but they're, like, medium-sized.
Well, there is a Squid King.
There's a Squid King.
Ooh,
true.
Ooh. Clam Monster and Squid King are two lovers. Rulers of the of separate sides
they're
of
lovers.
The ocean. No.
They're lovers. I want it.
Okay. Clam Monster is the just size think, of the just... Titanic. He's a giant clam, and if you go to the right spot, he's just chomping away.
Oh, I like that. Maybe he's got an ecosystem inside of him. Like, he's just always open. Yeah. Like, he's just got his own Mariana Trench. Maybe he's the Mariana Trench.
And then,
but he should send out smaller subordinates, because I really want to... I want to utilize the fact that they can just...
Yeah.
All the way through the water.
Like SpongeBob?
Yes, I want them to do okay. that, and I don't know if the big one doing that would be...
Terrifying.
Would you want the big one to just be doing
no,
that?
I want that to be like a weird monster in the bottom of the sea that he has to fight somewhere.
Maybe it's like a Subnautica thing where... I've never finished the game, but... He like the deeper he goes, the more dangerous his villains get.
Okay.
Like in the water. Okay. So I like that. Like he's constantly like traveling deeper to kill his stuff. So like shark the gigantic shark or whatever was just a shark he killed.
Yeah.
But like everything else was like, oh,
progressively
look.
As he goes deeper.
Yeah, like yeah. it goes as he goes deeper into the okay.
Which would make sense if he at the bottom he reaches the Squid King.
Yeah.
Which would
the Squid King. I imagine the Squid King and the Clam Monster are like enemies. Like they're like the two gods. They're Godzilla and King Kong. They're titans that fight every once in a while.
That's why you were so against Kaden a second ago, where it was just like you were trying to explain. He's like they're lovers.
Yes.
They're lovers.
No. Yeah. No. They're not lovers.
Okay.
I don't think that's why he was against it per se. I think it was just he didn't want.
There's many different factors.
Yeah. I think there's many different factors.
What is the last villain in the bottom right?
Actually, we skipped over one, too.
Oh?
Yeah,
what was
the middle one?
Yeah, there's Lobster Monster.
Oh, is it just Lobster?
Well.
So, clearly, I did not like this guy, and I was just trying to fill pages, and I was like, all right, here's his villains.
Yeah.
Lobster Monster, Crab Monster, Clam Monster.
Squid King.
Squid King.
Lobster Monster, I don't imagine that as a big threat. I imagine that as a medium.
It's a mini-boss he encounters every once in a while.
I imagine it's... If you fight Lobster Monster, you're fighting Shocker in the Spider-Man PS4 game. You fight him real fast, and you're done.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Caden, what does this last one look like? It looks like something, right? It looks like a thing.
It looks like Mr. Krabs.
Kind of, right? What is it?
It's something monster. It's Lazy Monster.
Let me see this.
No, look, it says Lazy Monster.
Let me see this.
Turn to the side. I ran out of room to write things. It's Lazy Monster.
What is it, though?
I don't know. I was coming. I think it's kind of cool.
Oh, yeah, Lazy Monster.
Maybe it's a sea slug.
I think it's a slug.
It's a
slug.
Sea slug works.
Yeah, it's a slug, and it's just his eyes.
Maybe it's a plague.
And his eyes are half shut, so I'm assuming that's the lazy boy.
It's a plague that consumes things, in like cargo ships. But it's I mean plague figuratively.
Maybe like does it consume cargo ships or
like
something?
I don't know. It's like a slow moving force of nature.
Okay.
And it's the lazy monster.
Maybe every once in a while he has to divert it from.
If any of the other characters, I know we're getting ahead of ourselves, but if any of these other characters were to run in to Barracuda, this would be the monster they teamed up to fight.
Oh, the lazy monster.
The lazy monster.
Why is that? Is he that strong?
I feel like he would be.
Do you picture him big or do you picture him?
I picture him big. Yeah.
Okay.
He's a big slug that just destroys everything.
He's definitely a character that works better running into other heroes and villains.
Yeah.
So that's a Barracuda. That is our thing. Does anyone want to give a whack at the recap?
Let's see. No.
I don't even know the song. All
right.
Oh, he. Speaking of which, 5 foot, less than 5 foot.
Oh yeah,
foot?
What's his size?
No, he's 4 foot.
4 foot.
Because he's got no. Look at his legs.
Yeah.
Look, like I'm gonna draw this guy eventually.
So
and
this
he's
is
gonna be nasty.
This person is the perfect. Like this is the one person Lioness actually has some height on.
Yeah. Oh my god! By a foot too.
Yeah.
If they fight, suddenly she gains all the confidence in the world, and she's the most dangerous villain you've ever seen.
For about 2 seconds.
For about
two seconds. Until she's eventually tossed across the room by like a spinning barracuda.
Yeah, I was about to say. But she fires a tabby cat at him, so it would work.
The barracuda hits her, tabby cat hits barracuda. They're both out.
Yeah, like a Creed 3 situation.
Exactly. Okay, I'll give a quick recap. The barracuda is a creature, a weird half man, half barracuda monstrosity that lives underneath the ocean and fights off. Has a lot of weird monsters and stuff. He fights underneath the ocean. He was created in a freak maybe even not so.
That's my favorite part about them.
Yeah,
about this guy is that he just. I like the fact that it was just a lightning bolt, a barracuda, and a child.
There's no real science behind this.
There's no science behind it.
No.
And it merged them all into one being.
It was probably an act of God, honestly.
Is God in this universe? Do we have a God in this universe?
I think so. I think it's us. I mean. I think we're the Trinity.
Oh, God.
I'm the Father, Chase is the Son, and Noah's the Holy Ghost. That's how it works. Because he doesn't eat anything.
That's true.
He's our Noah, yeah.
The Holy Ghost, right here.
Yeah, baby. He's basically, he's transparent. Me and Chase are opaque, but he's transparent.
Opaque?
Opaque?
I swear to God, I was so proud of myself. I thought I said it right. I was so proud of myself. God. I was like, I almost said opaque or whatever. I don't know. I think y'all could be wrong still.
I'm pretty sure we know it's opaque.
Yeah.
It's definitely not opaque.
Opaque.
Yeah, we're tired.
Right. Let me finish up the recap real fast. He fights a lot of underwater monsters and villains. Every once in a while, he joins a surface fight if they need him.
They don't.
His presence is thoroughly not welcome.
They don't call him. He just figures out where the fight is happening and shows up. Sometimes for the good, not always. No. Sometimes they're like, oh, man, that guy's here. Maybe Sharky definitely runs into him in their expeditions underwater.
Yes, uh-huh.
Maybe Sharky's his friend, because he's too young to understand that he's.
I think Sharky would.
He's a freak of nature.
I remember we talked about Sharky having a shark cave, and it was like underwater, and it was just a little shack. What if he just has a timeshare with Barracuda?
Every once in a while, they just share that.
That's the first any timeshare.
And every once in a while, their schedules they line it up so they
have to stay together. That'd be good.
But, yeah.
Who's the landlord of this timeshare? Is it the secret keeper?
No.
It's the secret keeper, isn't it?
The secret keeper.
Who's double booking these people?
He's got real estate everywhere.
I guess. Maybe that's his secret. He's like, go good.
No, I feel like that's a new character. Real estate. Come up. Just someone who gives like real estate to all these like these washed up people.
That is actually, I like
he's
that.
He's the Mr. Dinklage of this world.
Like a Mitzel Spiklik kind of guy. No, not even that. I would say like a weird like.
No, he's the Mr. Dinklage of this world.
No, I like the idea that he's just this like weird like underworld real estate agent.
What's that My Hero character who kind of just he's there when he's meeting all the villains, you know what I'm talking about?
Oh,
he was kidnapped.
Dobby.
No.
Yeah, that's exactly who I'm thinking of.
You know who I'm thinking
of? The guy that's always smoking.
Yeah, they go, the one who's always smoking a cigarette. Yeah. I can't think
of his
name.
The one they had to say. Yeah.
Hello,
yeah.
Shigaraki. Let me show you how to get some kids to follow you and become your little slaves. Hey, Shigaraki,
what?
Shigaraki, you're pretty handsy, right? Here's some kids.
Get it? Because Shigaraki's
I got it.
Because
he's got hands
all
over.
I don't remember this version of the character, Chase.
He's got a lot of hands.
No, we watched the dub. It's okay.
Oh, that's that makes sense.
Yeah, we watched
the
dub.
Does he sound like that?
Yeah.
A little bit.
No way.
Yeah.
Holy cow.
He sounds like it.
Not like that. He's a lot toned down than that. Like a lot more toned down.
Right.
He only likes
But you get it? Because Shigaraki's hands.
No, I got it.
He's got a lot of hands on him.
It's better than I would like to admit.
Okay, good.
That's not even that good.
Not even that good.
That's mean, Chase. That's mean. That's where I draw the line. That's mean. Apologize to your brother right now. Apologize to him.
That's where you draw the line?
That's where I draw the line. Apologize to him right
I'm waiting.
Now. Say what
apologize.
You... Apologize. Yes. Now.
Caden, I'm sorry.
Say I'm funny.
No, say what you're sorry for.
Caden, I'm sorry.
For what?
For nothing.
Wait.
Oh, hey.
Cap off the episode there. We got everything we needed.
Do
today,
we?
Right?
Do we have everything we need?
I think so.
I didn't get my apology.
Nor will you ever.
No.
Over
no.
my dead body. All right,
that can
be
arranged. Barracuda.
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 No, I'm also going to say what we're doing next week or get y'all.
Oh, yeah. What are we doing? What are we doing? I want to do Pterodactyl.
Pterodactyl next?
I want to do Pterodactyl.
You know, technically, that's
of course you would, you
that's actually the
nerd.
Next character on this in this book.
Oh, and he's got villains too.
All right,
he's got two villains.
No, the pterodactyl is an actual like rich character.
He's got something interesting.
Oh, he's got some interest in him.
All
right, fine.
Yeah, he's
you
a
get
rich...
it for now, you dinosaur nerd.
Pterodactyls aren't dinosaurs, and it's not even a real dinosaur because it's
you
a
dinosaur
it's a,
nerd.
We have it's a common name.
You dinosaur nerd.
You're an idiot.
Apologize to Noah right now.
Yeah.
You apologize to me.
Yeah.
I'll do it if you apologize. If Noah apologizes to me,
for
never.
What?
I don't
this is
know.
A weird cycle of
fine,
abuse.
Fine. You know what?
This is a weird triangle.
Will you apologize to him?
We all apologize.
I apologize to you.
Sure.
I'll apologize at the same time. At the same time. All right. Ready? Ready? All right. I'm sorry.
Okay.
All right. There we go.
And you see, that's how you have
for it. Nothing.
Thank you guys for listening. If anybody would like to contact the show, you can do so at theretconmicrowave@gmail.com. We are now available on multiple streaming services like Spotify and Apple and Amazon and all that kind of stuff. That's fun. It's pretty cool.
All podcast networks.
Yeah. Look at our
probably all of them.
Check out the website if you'd like to see this character for yourself in all his glory, and I'll have a little backstory on there too.
Okay, cool.
Barracuda.
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 Thank you so much for listening. This has been the Retcon Microwave. If you'd like to contact us, you can reach us at theretconmicrowave@gmail.com. If you'd like to support the show, tell a friend. And if you'd like to know more about the characters we're creating, you can check out the website in the description. I mean, unless I haven't created it yet, but, well, soon enough. It'll be there. Okay, bye.